The help of the Almighty, first pray to the Almighty to bestow upon me His truth, His wisdom, and that I may be a worthy messenger of conveying His message, and so we can sanctify His name and bring shalom to the world with God's help, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum. My name is Rabbi Yisrael David Weiss. I'm from here with a group of my esteemed colleagues from Jews United Against Zionism. And we are here to stand in solidarity. The occasion is this event of Rise Up from SJP here in Rutgers, in Brunswick, and the other different organizations here that are joining together. We are very thankful, and I'm humbled that we're given the opportunity to speak here. For us, it is a great privilege. Unfortunately, the reason that we feel always compelled to come and speak up for the issue of Palestine is, of course, everybody is the Almighty's creation, and this is humanity, and what people call human rights, we call godliness, and God's requirement. But on us as Jewish people lies a much deeper, crucial issue, an obligation of speaking up, because what is being done, of course, is being done in our name, in the name of the Jewish religion, in the name of Jewish people. And it's the Nakba, this terrible destruction, this terrible tragedy, and there is no words to describe. This is well over 60 years that this has been going on. This is over 100 years, actually. And the world, every time when people who are humanitarians, people who feel obligated to speak up because they have good hearts, as the vast majority of people around the world have good hearts, and they do not in any manner want to see injustice, yet in the issue of Palestine they are silent. And the reason being that they are constantly being fed that this is an issue of a religion against another religion. This is an issue of Jewish people who have been so oppressed throughout the generations, are simply claiming what is theirs. And there are some people, individuals, who are inhumane, who are racist, and so forth. I mean, the words are vile, the words are really repugnant to speak, but that is the impression, that is the portrayal that is constantly presented throughout the decades for so long in the issue of Palestine and the issue of the occupation. It is justified constantly in the name of the Almighty. There's nothing more repugnant, there's nothing more vile, there's nothing more that we can't, as Jews, we can't accept this. Our hearts are torn, our hearts, we cry when we see the suffering of the people of Palestine. I have a few of my colleagues here. There's two or three of them who are from eighth generation Palestinian. I just had the fellow who wrote the book of Rise, what is the name of it?
Palestine Rise.
And he was speaking about Darius, and I said, I know Darius, and my colleague here, Rabbi Rosenberg, his grandfather, talks to me many times about that. They're actually from Palestine, and they came and they said, you have no idea, we were there. Their relatives were there. They were there at that time, their relatives, and they stood and watched how their friends, their brethren, their sisters and brothers of Palestine were living. They had been living together. They had been living in the same courtyards. They had been babysitting each other's children, which is the most precious object that one had. They were living as people. You live with your neighbor. That is a given. Why should there be any problem? A difference of religion. Yes, we have clearly a difference of way of how we serve the Almighty, but that was never an impediment. That was never a reason. God says that you're supposed to respect. And just the Almighty is compassionate, you must be compassionate. This is part of our basics of religion. And so there was never a question of some mistrust, of a rift between us. And they said, and all of a sudden, this movement of Zionism, which is a transformation of our religion, Religion is subservience to God. Our covenant to God was to be subservient, to uphold His commandments, to be kind, to be just, and so forth. And all of a sudden this movement came that was alienated, that was totally estranged from the religion. It was a movement of people who detested their religion, and they decided to give themselves some type of respect. In other words, that they should be accepted in the world. So they gave that they simply hijacked. They've taken the name of Judaism, the symbols of Judaism, so they can have what people like eat, to have the cake and eat it. They, you know, they should be able to walk. Transgress all the laws of the Torah. At the same time, they should be respected and heroes amongst the Jewish people. They walk around saying, oh, we're protecting the Jewish people, we're going and speaking up. They go to the evangelistic Christians and say, we're going here because they wave the Bible as a deed. They say, see, in the Torah it says God gave the Jewish people this land and it is ours, and we're just standing up for the rights, totally ignoring the voice of the ones who are true to the religion, the ones who are religious for centuries and for hundreds and literally thousands of years, who never broached this concept, never dreamed of going and occupying another people. Yet they come and they present themselves as the representative of the Jewish people. They call it the Jewish state. They go up, and anybody who dares to speak up against what they're of the occupation, they're self-hating Jews. They ridicule us. They you go to, right across from Manhattan, right to the coast by here, the largest concentration of religious Jews is right across the Williamsburg Bridge from Manhattan. It's Williamsburg, and you go through. It's like you're stepping back in time. You won't find one Israeli flag, not one single Israeli flag. And it's the largest concentration of religious Jews, people who are giving their lives to the religion. They pay for private education, large families, 6, 10 children and more in the families, because we don't have family planning in our, it's forbidden for us. You have large, we pay for our own private schools because it's imperative for us. We have special Jewish education. They paid with their lives. It cost them the food, kosher, like halal food, costs money, everything, and they're giving their lives. Why all of a sudden, when it comes to the issue of occupation, of Zionism, of being loyal to the state of Israel, they're not there? Is it because they're lacking in their closeness, in their loyalty to the Almighty and the Torah? Obviously, that can't be, because they're giving their lives for their religion. So you really, anybody who's a little intelligent, who's a little illogical, should step back and say, why are the more religious people, whether they're living in Jerusalem, or whether they're living in England, or Australia, invariably the very religious communities, do not accept the occupation. Not only they don't accept over the Green Line, not only they're talking about a two-state solution, no, they're talking about that this occupation, the existence of a so-called Jewish state, a material concept of having a piece of land, that they say that's antithetical, that's not what Judaism is. You've totally totally falsely translated what it's all about. This is not what we're dreaming of. My grandparents died in Auschwitz. The majority of my family, they're from Eastern Europe. They were killed, they died, and this is an ongoing history of our trials and tribulations by the Spanish Inquisition, by the Crusades. Jews gave their lives to serve God. This is not what we gave. This is not the service of God to take an Uzi, to go up and to wound and paralyze your child. Your words were so touching. I mean, I can't follow you, your speech, but I can only speak from our hearts with the Jewish people. I say, how dare you? How dare you? What our generations gave their lives for, what we stood up for, to serve God, to be compassionate, to be alive to what we believe, that if a Jew is practicing the Torah, he's simply representing closeness to God, not to kill, not to steal. And how dare you take our religion and sully it and claim that it is a simple concept of a strong Olympic team, and that we're stronger than you, we have a stronger army, and that we occupy. This occupation is vile, is shatan, is Satan. This is nothing with our religion. We have many of them on our site, NKUSA. We have many, look at the book Rabbis Speak Out, a compilation of universally all the rabbinical authorities around the world at the time of the inception of Zionism stood up and said, wait, this is not us. We oppose this. Who are the Zionists? They were people who detested Israel. Theodor Herzl made an announcement to papers that he's not circumcising his son, which was the covenant between us and God. And this goes on and on. There's a Nachum Begin, others, every one of them. All these people, Jabotinsky, I don't know if you're well aware of these terrorists. But anyway, Jabotinsky said Jews with payas, but this is called payas, the airlocks, and Birchin, the second-class citizens, did not have the right to vote in the Holy Land when they decided to make their so-called Jewish state. This is vile. The chief rabbi of Palestine in 1947 pleaded with the United Nations. He said, "We furthermore wish to express our definite opposition to a Jewish state in Palestine, in any part of Palestine." This was the chief rabbi of Palestine. But nobody even knows about this. You come to universities and they have the Hillel houses, which was actually created for Jews to have a haven, a place to pray and to eat kosher and to serve God. And yet they've again usurped out this holy man Hillel's name, and they're coming and they're occupying and committing these terrible crimes. We as Jews are here to stand up and say, this is not Judaism. It's not us. It's not our religion. And it's not even the majority of Jews who are around the world. They don't accept this. It's the one who has the strong microphone. It's a movement called Zionism. It's called the Zionist State of Israel. It's not a Jewish state. And we pray every day in our synagogues, in our teachers, the chief rabbis of Palestine. One of them lived here, actually, for many years. He left Palestine because he didn't want to be under the occupation, lived in New York. For many years, his name was Rabbi Tadalan, and pleaded, cried constantly. He said, we have to constantly pray that it should end this occupation speedily and peacefully without any further bloodshed and suffering, not of the Muslim people, not of the Arab people, not of the Jews. This is something that is simply, as I say, a work of Shatan. It's not logical. When people say humanitarian rights, we say it's against godliness. And it's so clearly not right. It just does not, it doesn't lie on anybody's logic why people could be so strongly in support of an occupation that doesn't reckon with the failings, with the suffering of a people for so many years that they don't have water. In Gaza we went to visit, they have brackets, water, and not food and not medical aid and so forth. But this is something every year we believe is a test. Every life person goes through a test. This is our test. We should not be intimidated. Do not think that if you're standing up against the occupation, that you are automatically involving yourself in a war, in a conflict between religions or between God or something, and that you could be labeled anti-Semitic. That one who's labeling you anti-Semitic, he's a simple con artist, he's a thief. He has no right to label you, and do not be intimidated. If you're a Jew, do not be intimidated. You are not a self-hating Jew. On the contrary, the ones who exacerbate and cause anti-Semitism is this state of Israel. They're the ones who has the hands sullied and bloodied of the blood of the Palestinians and the Jews and the exacerbation worldwide of anti-Semitism. They are the enemies of the Jews and of God. So let me say to you, please, stand up, pray to God every day for the speedy and God help peaceful dismantlement of this occupation to the end. It should be totally dismantled, a free Palestine, a free Holy Land. At the same time, do not be silent. Stand up and know God will protect you. Stand up for the rights of the godly creation of our brethren in Palestine, the Muslims, the Arabs, the Palestinians, and my Jewish brethren who every day get brutally beaten. As we're standing here, my brethren who are Jewish constantly demonstrate against them. They're trying to force them into the army. Since the 1920s, our spokespeople and rabbis were assassinated, and it's in their own records. So stand up and pray to God and do, and we will, with God's help, prevail, because the Almighty is the one who this world belongs to. And eventually, He will reward our actions with speedy and total, God help, dismantlement of the impediment to peace called the Zionist State of Israel and a free Palestine, so we can again, as Jews, We can join our Palestinian brethren, return to them their freedom, their respect, their land, and say, here is to show gratefulness for the hundreds and hundreds of years that Jews who have lived amongst Muslim countries, when we ran away from the Inquisition, you stood by us. We are trying to reward you and try, we can't compensate, but help you rebuild your respect, your lives. God help that should happen soon in our days. Thank you. The Almighty is the one to whom this world belongs to, and eventually He will reward our actions with speedy and total, God help, their land, and say, here is to show gratefulness for the hundreds and hundreds of years that Jews who have lived amongst Muslim countries when we ran away from the Inquisition, you stood by us. We are trying to reward you and try, we can't compensate, but help you rebuild your respect, your lives. God help that should happen soon in our days. Thank you.